two fixed charges A and B of 5 microcoulomb each are separated by a distance of 6 cm. C is the midpoint of the line joining A and B. A charge Q of minus 5 microcoulomb is shot perpendicular to the line joining A and B through C with a kinetic energy of 0.06 joule. The charge Q comes to rest at a point D. The distance CD is. Here we need to find the distance CD. First we can draw the diagram according to this question. Okay, so there is a charge A and B. There are two charges A and B. This is charge A and this is charge B. The distance between these two charges, it is 6 meter, right? It is given in the question. The midpoint is C. This charge is 5 microcoulomb. This charge is also 5 microcoulomb. It is a midpoint. Okay, C. Now, there is a charge at this midpoint. There is a charge. This charge is having energy 0.06 joule. The kinetic energy of the charge is 0.06 joule. So we are considering that charge here. It is the initial stage. Okay, the charge was having energy 0.06 joule. So here we are going to find the total potential energy. Okay, this is minus 5 microcoulomb. We are finding potential energy in the initial case. The equation is potential energy U equal to K into Q1 Q2 by R12. This is Q1, this is Q2, this is Q3. Okay, potential energy U equal to K into Q1 Q2 by R12 plus K into Q2 Q3 by R23 plus K into Q3 Q1 by R31. It is the equation for potential energy, right? The value of K 9 into 10 raised to 9, right? So we are substituting all the values in the equation. The charge Q1 is 5 microcoulomb. 5 microcoulomb is 5 into 10 raised to minus 6 coulomb. Similarly, Q2 is 5 microcoulomb. It is 5 into 10 raised to minus 6 coulomb. Here also it is Q2. Q2 is 5 into 10 raised to minus 6 coulomb. And Q3 is minus 5 into 10 raised to minus 6 coulomb. To convert microcoulomb into coulomb, we need to multiply it by 10 raised to minus 6. So we can substitute all the values. Potential energy U equal to 9 into 10 raised to 9. Here K is common. So here K 9 into 10 raised to 9 I am taking outside. It will be 5 into 10 raised to minus 6 into 5 into 10 raised to minus 6 all divided by R12. The distance between Q1 and Q2 is 6 meter by 6 plus K into Q2 Q3. So here it will be Q2 and Q3. So 5 into 10 raised to minus 6, Q3 is minus 5 into 10 raised to minus 6 all divided by the distance between Q1 and the distance between Q2 and Q3. It will be 3 because it is midpoint. So it will be by 3 plus 5 into 10 raised to minus 6 into minus 5 into 10 raised to minus 6 all divided by this distance is also 3 meter. Okay. Now, if we are solving everything, we will get potential energy U equal to minus 0.1125 joule. That is the potential energy. Here, this charge is possessing a kinetic energy also. So, what will be the total energy? The total energy will be Ke plus Pe. Kinetic energy is, it is given in the question, 0.06 joule. So, it will be total energy equal to minus 0.1125 plus 0.06. The answer is minus 0.0525 joule. That is the total energy. Now in the second case, because of this kinetic energy, it is moving to a point D and it is going to the point D and it is at the point D, it is at rest. So when the charge is moving to a distance, the kinetic energy is converting into potential energy. We are going to apply law of conservation of energy. Law of conservation of energy saying the total energy will be always a constant, right? So charge is moving. Now the total energy is minus 0.0525 joule. That is the total energy. It should be constant. In this case, we are going to find the potential energy using the same equation. That will be the total energy because according to law of conservation of energy, the total energy should be constant. Now it is having a potential energy. Now it is at rest. There is no kinetic energy. All the kinetic energy has been converted into potential energy. So that will be equal to total energy. Okay, the potential energy is increasing, kinetic energy is decreasing. So we can find the potential energy here. It will be 9 into 10 raised to 9, the K we are taking it out into here. Charges are, this is Q1, Q2 and Q3, right? So Q1 is 5 into 10 raised to minus 6 into Q2 is 5 into 10 raised to minus 6 all divided by the distance is 6 meter, right? Plus here Q2, this is Q2, this is Q3, right? So this is Q2, this is Q3. So 5 into 10 raised to minus 6 into minus 5 into 10 raised to minus 6. This distance is BD, B to D, right? This distance is BD. This point is D, okay? This point is D. Plus here, 5 into 10 raised to minus 6 into minus 5 into 10 raised to minus 6 all divided by this distance is AD, okay? Now by symmetry, the distance AD and distance BD, it is equal. AD and BD, it is equal. So this is D. Using symmetry, BD equal to AD. Instead of this BD, I have given AD. Instead of this AD, we have given AD only. I am changing this BD to AD, okay? Because AD and BD both are equal. Now we can solve it, okay? If we are solving it, we will get AD equal to 5 meter. Just do the calculation, you will get AD equal to 5 meter. So we got this distance. This distance is AD, that is 5 meter. And what is this distance? Okay, this distance is 3 meter. So we can apply Pythagoras principle. So we need to find CD, right? CD square is equal to AD square minus AC square. This is AC, so it is 3 meter. So we can substitute that value. It will be CD square equal to 5 square minus 3 square. CD square equal to 16. Then CD will be equal to 4 meter. So the distance from the midpoint to the charge, midpoint to the point D, is 4 meter.